Want to speak real Vietnamese from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at VietnamesePod101.com.
Hello everyone, welcome back to VietnamesePod101.com, the fastest, easiest and most fun way to learn Vietnamese. This video today is going to be about vocabulary where you can use these words to describe some common hobbies in Vietnam. I think it's very similar to anywhere in the world because there are some typical, some common things that we like to do when we have free time, and let's see what they are. Đi uống cà phê. Đi uống cà phê. Đi uống cà phê. Đi means to go. Uống means to drink. Cà phê means coffee. So, đi uống cà phê means to go for coffee or to go to the coffee shop or to go drinking coffee together. That's it. Đi uống cà phê. Usually, the most common thing that we would do when we have free time is to go to the coffee shop to meet up with friends and to chit-chat, to just to gossip for the whole morning or the whole afternoon. So, đi uống cà phê. Remember that when you come to Vietnam and when you have free time, just go out to any shops that you can easily see everywhere and grab a cup of coffee and enjoy the weather. Đi uống cà phê. Lướt web. Lướt web. Lướt web. That means to surf the internet. Lướt web. Or we can also use the word online. Online. But in Vietnamese, we will say, we will pronounce a little bit different. We say online. 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 Okay, that means to surf the internet, to surf the Facebook, or to surf whatever you want, just to be online. And it's very common when you go to the coffee shop, when you đi uống cà phê, you will see a lot of people that are just on their phone and just to lướt web.
Đi du lịch. Đi du lịch. Đi du lịch. Đi du lịch means to go traveling or to travel.
It's very, very common in Vietnam when you have a few days off or when you have a vacation. So the number one priority that would come in your mind is just to go traveling. Đi du lịch. Okay, have you ever been to some famous places in Vietnam? We have Nha Trang, we have Đà Nẵng, we have Phú Quốc, we have Sài Gòn, Sapa, Hạ Long, all of them. Everywhere has their own beauty and local food and nice weather and amazing views. So if you have free time, think about traveling around Vietnam and explore the beauty of Vietnam.
Chơi thể thao. Chơi thể thao. Chơi thể thao. Chơi thể thao means to play sports. So thể thao means sports in general. But if you want to know a little bit more vocabulary about sports, then we have yoga. Yoga. Yoga for yoga. We have tập gym. Tập gym. Tập gym means to exercise or to work out.
So there are a lot of sports that you can do in your free time, and number one sport in Vietnam is bóng đá. Bóng đá. Kids play everywhere after school, even adults plays everywhere after work, and it's very, very common. It's the number one sport in Vietnamese people's heart.
Nấu ăn tại nhà. Nấu ăn tại nhà. Nấu ăn tại nhà. Nấu ăn tại nhà means to cook at home. And we really enjoy cooking at home when we have free time, inviting friends or relatives to come to our home to enjoy food together. Especially we can drink as much as possible and we don't have to worry when they will close the shop. So nấu ăn tại nhà is also a very nice hobby. Nấu ăn tại nhà.
Đọc sách. Đọc sách. Đọc sách.
Đọc sách means to read books or reading. So đọc sách is also very very common, especially I think it's for everyone. Nowadays we tend to use Kindle to bring books everywhere with us, but đọc sách is also a very nice and great culture that we'd like to encourage young people to do. When we have free time, we also have some coffee shops where people just come to read books. It's very quiet, very nice designed, good drinks, and you can just enjoy the whole afternoon in the autumn.
Đi xem phim. Đi xem phim. Đi xem phim.
Đi xem phim means to go to the movies or to go to the theater. Đi means to go, xem means to watch, and phim means movie. Đi xem phim. It's also like just nothing to say because it's just too common. We can watch movies anywhere, but it's still more interesting to watch movies at the theater, right? Because of the speaker and the big screen and the environment, especially for blockbusters. So đi xem phim is also a very common hobby in Vietnam.
Nghe nhạc. Nghe nhạc. Nghe nhạc. Nghe nhạc means to listen to music. Nghe nhạc.
I think I don't have to say anything about this because it's not only for Vietnamese people, but also everybody would love music. Like me personally, I listen to music like as much as possible. When I am on the way to work, when I'm on the way to home, or when I have lunch, literally every time. So
nghe nhạc. Nghe nhạc. Quay TikTok. Quay TikTok. Quay TikTok means to make videos on TikTok.
Yes, they are so big and they're also very popular in Vietnam. So nowadays a lot of people, including me, also enjoy making videos on TikTok. This is like the best way to kill time, you know, and it's also very interesting. So I was really, really impressed to see how creative people are on the internet, especially TikTok. So it's just so big in Vietnam. People are crazy making videos to post on TikTok or Facebook.
Làm YouTuber. Làm YouTuber. Làm YouTuber.
Or you can say làm YouTube.
Làm YouTube.
So YouTube here means YouTube. Làm YouTube. Làm YouTube means like you just spend time to make videos on YouTube and to post it on YouTube. Just like what I'm doing now. This is just my favorite job and I love it. So when I have free time, I make some videos on YouTube and share with my friends about Vietnamese, English, cooking and everything. So this is just one of the best things to do in your free time, just to share how your life is with your friend, people, and to share the skills that you have with people. So remember, làm YouTube. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. And don't forget to like this video, subscribe the channel, and visit the website VietnamesePod101.com to learn more Vietnamese. Thank you so much for everything. See you in the next one.
Xin chào và hẹn gặp lại.